Mark, the last time that we met, you took her in to visit with her counsel. Did I ask you to do that?
He says yes.
Okay. Can we go back there? Would that be okay?
He says that he wants to go into something different this time.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Where do you want to go, buddy? Is he asking me to take you someplace else? Is that the question?
Yes.
Okay, very good. I'm happy to do that for you. That's fine. Well, okay, Mark, would you do me a favor? Would you take our friend here to her library, wherever that is? If you could give her a visual and put the visual of what her reference library might look like, where would that be?
What I'm looking at right now is a big dark room. I see one book. This looks like a magic book. This book looks like it's huge, Richard. It's probably about 2 feet long.
Okay.
And about 5 foot high. It's huge.
Very good. Is there any writing on the cover of it?
None. I see, it looks like an eye on it. Oh. There's no writing.
Take a look at the eye.
Have you ever seen a gemstone?
Sure.
It looks like an eye. It looks like an eye, but the gemstone is an eye.
What color is it? What color is this gemstone?
Red.
Red. Oh, okay. Take a real close look at it. Is it vibrating in any way, or is it just a flat kind of surface, or how does it, is it energetic?
Rough, it is. It's very energetic. It's got like a rough texture, almost like cement. The energy of this, it feels as if something that I can explain this to. Filling water, it feels like there's moistness to it.
Oh.
It's absolutely not wet at all. The book feels moist.
Moist, very good. Okay.
It has hard texture to it.
Can you, in your mind's eye, could you open that book for us? Open that up.
It's opened.
What do you see?
Blank.
Blank. Okay. White. All right. Are they pages?
Yes.
Pages are okay. Very good. All right. Well, do me a favor, Mark. Would you help her open the book to a page that might be good for us to reference at this moment to take a look at? It might be helpful for Raylene. What comes to mind when I ask you to open to a page?
I'm opening the page, and I'm opening a door. It's no longer a book.
I see. I understand. So we've kind of gone through the book and into a room. And so tell me what the door looks like before we open it. Is it wood? Is it...
No, it's light. There's no wood. It's not texture at all. It's light. I see something that I could push open, or it's something that could push open to me. It's going back and forth. No, I'm outside. I'm surrounded by forest, trees.
Oh, excellent. How beautiful. And can you see any sky?
No, I don't see any sky. I don't see... it's very dark.
Very dark. All right, so here's what I want you to do. Mark, do me a favor. Lighten this visual up a little bit. Let's shift the focus a little bit so we can see a little bit more clearly. What kind of trees do you see?
I see pine trees.
Pine trees. Okay, very good. Would you do me a huge favor?
Uh-huh.
I've asked people to do this before, and I'm just curious what this feels like. Would you go over to the nearest pine tree and stand in front of it? Put your hand on the pine tree. What does that feel like?
It doesn't feel like a tree. It feels very soft, very subtle. I'm not even getting poked by it.
Any energy at all associated with it? Going up, down, sideways?
Yes, it's going up and down. I feel alive. I know I'm alive right now. I feel energized.
Excellent. Would you do me a favor? Give this tree a hug. G- Give it an emotional hug. Just put your wrap your arms around this pine tree. And what's the feeling or message that you get from this pine tree?
She's telling me I'm loved. This is a female presence in this tree.
Okay, very good. A female presence in the tree. And so... I'm sorry?
She's telling you thank you.
Oh, well, what does Raylene look like to you? From your perspective, this person hugging you, what does she look like?
She says mud.
Mud, okay. Like earth. More earth than energy. Okay, that's just an image.
Oh.
Don't take it personally.
No, I'm not. That's a different kind of answer.
Well, you know, it's unusual to get this perspective now. So let's just say, Emily, let me ask you, if I can ask you questions and you can answer, I would appreciate it. And so do you generally view humans as mud, or is this just Raylene, or how do you view humans?
She's telling me that she views humans as beautiful people.
Uh-huh.
She sees them as human form. She says that right now I'm not in a dimension that is earthly.
Okay.
Which she's seeing the way she is.
Okay. So what dimension are you in? Are you referring to where we are right now in this after we've gone through this door?
No, she's referring to the dimension that I'm in right now with her.
Oh, I see. Okay. I see where you're having... I'm sorry, you say fifth?
She says fifth.
Fifth. Okay, very good. So we're having this conversation with you in the fifth dimension. And what dimension are we in, me and Raylene?
Third.
Okay, very good. I'm just curious how that works. So very interesting, Emily, and thank you. Is there any message you would like to give to us humans that we could pass along to other humans with regard to trees and how we might want to take care of them or connect with them or be part of their journey?
She says, I wish for humans to be gentle to the earth, to recycle and not to cut down our precious life. She's referring to the tree as being life, which it is, life force.
Does anybody ever get annoyed when you look around and you see humans just completely chopping down trees and not, you know, putting up new ones?
She says, not so much as annoyed, but I feel the pain from the other trees, and I feel the pain that I'm losing family around me.
True. Well, how do you guys communicate with other trees?
She's talking about vibration, and she says, from within the roots themselves, and now she's talking about the wind. She says, from the wind, when we move our leaves, our branches, it's a form of communication to other trees.
Oh.
Very vibrational.
I want you to go to the last day of this lifetime, just because we don't have much time. What's the occurrence? Where were you? What happened?
There is a panther.
Oh, how cool. So you fought a panther. Yeah, that is kind of scary. You fought a panther. Was the panther in the woods?
Yes.
No wonder you're afraid of going into the woods. Now, let's freeze the frame just before Mr. Panther makes his attack. Can we?
Uh-huh.
Take a look at Mr. Panther. Are you familiar with him?
No, but I don't feel safe.
Don't feel safe. Okay, but don't forget, here we are. You're in mm-hmm. Colorado. I'm in Santa Monica. Mr. Panther is somewhere else right now in your memory.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And I know there's fear associated with it, but I want you to let go of that for a minute, because we're going to do something really strange. We're going to ask to speak to the panther directly. Can we? Take a look at that fella. Let me ask you, do you normally incarnate as a panther, or have you incarnated in other forms?
I have been human many times.
Many times?
I've also been fish.
Really? Okay. Is there a hierarchy in terms of panther, fish, human, or are they just all life forms, equal unto themselves?
We are all the same life form. Our souls are equal.
So let me ask you this, Mr. Panther. When you were in human form, did you feel like you were fully there or just partially there? I mean, was all of your energy in that form? Or was it like partially your energy was back home between lives? That's my...
But as I was human, I did not miss any of my spiritual home as I had no awareness of it. Being a panther, I have complete awareness of who my spirit is, where I come from.
Interesting. And now let me ask you, Mr. Panther, if you could give us a visual of what you look like between lives, even if it's a color or a form or...
I'm looking at a ball of light. This is not a ball. Good example. A bright light, like the light bulb.
Uh-huh.
That's exactly what I'm looking at, except for it's more pure white with a tad of green.
A tad of green. Okay. And so I would ask, Mr. Panther, do you consider yourself a young soul, an old soul, or where are you on your pantheon of journey of souls?
I'm very evolved. I guess you would consider me in human terms ancient.
Fantastic. So in this guise, in this memory, you then attacked our friend, Mark, and did you eat him or did you just kill him?
He's telling me that he ate me.
So I assume, Mr. Panther, that you've been eaten before as well, correct?
Yes, I have. Not in my current panther form. He's indicating that he lived to be an old age, and he died of malnourishment.
Very good. All right, very good. And I'm sorry to skip around so much, but Mr. Panther, I appreciate you talking to us, and we're going to get back to you. Now, tell me the council again. How many people are in there?
Seven?
And is there, I think we spoke to the spokesperson, didn't we? Is it a male or female?
Male. He's giving me the name Adam.
Adam. Okay, very good. Yes, I remember Adam. Thank you.
So,
Adam, why was she shown this lifetime that was in the book? That is the book of her life, obviously. Her library has this one giant book, and what did she learn from this lifetime in the jungle in Africa?
He's telling me it's the reason why I'm afraid of forest, trees, nature. I'm terrified of it.
Okay, very good. So we did learn something today, didn't we? Because there's not anything to fear, is there? The reason she's terrified of a forest because she actually got attacked by an old friend of hers in the forest, eaten, but also nourished, Mr. Panther. So it's all part of that journey. So I see you were directly shown this lifetime today so you could release the fear associated with forest.
Yes. Do you want to know something interesting, Rich? My husband's been trying to get me to go camping this year and I won't go. I'm afraid to go.
Not anymore?
No.